The next UFC pay-per-view event is pretty fantastic, at least on paper. It's headlined by two title fights. Yes, one of them is for an interim belt, but nonetheless, I think if you're going to enjoy some adult beverages during the card, it should be something magnificent. I'm Flyin Brian J, and this is my beer pairing suggestion for UFC 213. Todd the Axeman by Surly Brewing Company out of Minneapolis, Minnesota. The number one reason I chose this beer is because of the artwork. It reminds me a bit of a Grim Reaper, or perhaps Robert the Reaper Whittaker. It's also kind of scary looking. Do you know who else is scary AF? Third round Yoel, Soldier of God Romero, and first round Amanda the Lioness Nunes. Todd the Axeman is brewed with just a single malt and two hops, yet pulls out a dynamic and robust flavor profile similar to Valentina Bullet Shevchenko. She is known solely as a kickboxer, but as she showed against Juliana Pena, she is a skillful and diverse mixed martial artist. The main event of UFC 213 is for an undisputed bantamweight title, and the co-main event is for an interim belt that many fight fans believe to be an indication of the current best middleweight fighter on the planet. This beer is officially labeled an India Pale Ale, but with the level of hops apparent in the beer, along with the rather high alcohol by volume, one might consider Todd the Axeman to be a double India Pale Ale. A 4-pack of 16-ounce cans of Todd the Axeman is about $15 American, so it's kind of pricey. I don't fault you at all if you don't go with this beer, although I do think it is definitely worth the price. If you choose this magnificent creation or you go with something you're more comfortable with, even if it's big box beer, please drink responsibly. Cheers.